Here again, we find Alice wandering around alone in a place that she has never been and entering into a private art studio. She knocks on the door and soon gets the attention of a young male animator who is seated at work. The animator acknowledges Alice, after which Alice states, "I would like to watch you draw some funnies." Notice that Alice does not introduce herself. Therefore, the animator has no idea who this girl is, where she came from, or where her parents are. She has therefore become objectified. She is nothing more than an object. But wait, did you notice Alice's body language after she states, "I would like to watch you draw some funnies"? Let us watch again. Now, in slow motion. Alice rubs herself in her crotch area and, with a smiling face, projects a flirtatious disposition towards the adult male animator. Notice the animator's reaction. Again, the animator does not ask Alice her name, or where her parents are, or if she is lost, or if she needs some sort of assistance. As a man and a father, these are questions that I would have asked immediately. A responsible mother would have done the same. Instead, we see the male animator quickly jump up out of his seat and then anticipates Alice's arrival into his chair. Again, I must remind the viewer that the premise of this Alice film is that Alice is without adult supervision, has wandered into a place that she has never been, has entered into a private location, has spoken with a man that she has never met, wears revealing clothing and makeup, and has projected a flirtatious disposition via the rubbing of her crotch area. Let us review this sequence in full. Alice is now seated and begins to watch a cartoon that the animator presumably created. But did you notice something strange? While viewing the film, the animator repeatedly touches Alice on the shoulders, at times crouching closer to her. Alice, who is fixated on the animated film before her, appears to be oblivious to the touch of the pedophile. Thank you. On a subconscious level, a deeper pedophilic story has been recognized. In many cases, the viewer has already subconsciously sensed that there is something strange happening here, that somehow things are not as they appear. Notice how the subconscious awareness is projected in the next scene, within which we find the subliminal placing of the danger sign on the table, a sign that Alice clearly indexes, subliminally pointing out to the viewer that she is in fact in danger. We then find four male animators gathered in a room. Notice their carefree dispositions. Does it appear as if these males are socially responsible adults? Does it appear as if these males are spiritually evolved? Would you leave your 4-year-old daughter with these men? Again, Alice is in danger. Notice how the animator crouches in front of Alice, holding her hand while Alice plays with his fingers. So, who is this animator? Is it some low-level artist? Is it some professional actor? No, this animator is Walt Disney himself. Notice that Alice is now back at home and is being prepared for bed, while Alice's hand is tugging at her mother's clothes near her mother's crotch area. We cannot apply the same pedophilic themes as was present in the art studio scenes. In this case, Alice is at home being cared for by a woman, a caretaker, who is putting her to sleep. Furthermore, Alice is in a location that she is familiar with. There are no perceivable dangers here, which lie in stark contrast to what was evident in the art studio scenes. I make this point to illustrate that we must be careful to place what we see in context. A mother putting her daughter to sleep is very much different, contextually speaking, than a 4-year-old girl wandering around in a place that she has never been without the guidance of an adult, entering into a place that is personal, concealed, or secret, and being secluded in the company of young, juvenile acting males. It is important that we keep these types of situational distinctions in mind, and that it is critical that we see things contextually as to properly define the subliminal messages present in all forms of popular media.